What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another Sinoalice video here on the channel, and we have some surprise awesome QOL developer updates to talk about that it should be dropping throughout periodic dates. Some will be coming out tomorrow with the update, and then some will be coming out later on throughout the next couple weeks. But first of all, new information. We pretty much have already talked about this, but they're just showing you guys what the new kind of weapons are going to be for an End of the Summer Dreams event, which starts on the 20th of August, and it will last until the 3rd of September. So we're going to have, from what I understand, the banner for the Poacher's Fest. They are, from what I understand, seasonal limited units, which means basically they're going to be in relation probably to summer events. So probably every so often they will bring those up. Even if we're not in summer, they technically could just bring the summer event. I mean, PokeLabo has done so many things not on schedule that I would not put it past them to, like, in like the winter do like some kind of random summer event or something like that. But at any rate, they should all make a return at some point. So even if you don't really want to pull for these particular weapons, and you're really trying to save for something else, you still could have a chance down the line later on to get them. So anyway, this is the Sifter of Mystery. So this looks like this is the Legendary Hammer. This is going to come from the Sleeping Beauty Poacher. So it's got Magic Debuff 2, then Evil Thunder of Onslaught Tier 3 skill, and it maxes out at 6178 total points. Cost of 17, that is at max level broken. So unless you're a whale, you ain't going to be getting this much power from it. So just to be clear on that. And then we have Rake of Langur, which is going to be the weapon from Little Mermaid from her Paladin version. And it's going to be as well 6170, so 8 less total stats, which basically the same thing. At max level broken, cost of 17. Tier 2 physical debuff on the support skill, and then a Tier 3 Sandstorm Barrier on the Story and Coliseum skill. Then we go into the book. So it's going to have 6645 total limit break stats at cost of 18. With Blade Deployment 2 and Shackles of Incantation 3 for the skills there. 6645. So significantly higher on stats. And this should not be time limited, I don't think. But correct me if I'm wrong in the comment section. And then we have Cool Breeze, Deploy Square Formation 2. Barrier Masters Nocturne 3 for the attack skills. And then you guys have total points of 6659. So it's right around close to what Book of Observation is. So I don't think these are time limited, but they all may be time limited. So if I'm wrong, let me know, guys, in the comment section down below. But I know for sure the jobs for Little Mermaid and Sleeping Beauty are time limited, or seasonal limited, if you guys would just basically time limited. So next, let's go into the upcoming updates, which is the big thing which I want to talk about in today's video. So new features. Guarantee what we're going to be getting on 8/20 is we're going to be raising the player cap. So tomorrow's update, we are going to have an increased player cap. Now, I've heard different things for everything. So that could be on tomorrow. We could get like 10 levels. We could get 20 levels. We could get 50 levels. We could get 100 levels. I will be happy as long as we get minimum 20 levels. I think that'll get us enough cost overall in 20 more ranks that I can at least slot in to fill up my main grid, because right now I'm on 19 weapons because I don't have enough cost to run even like an SR at the last 20th weapon because I was trying to fit in more legendaries. So hopefully we get at least 20 rank levels is like my goal. Next, they also are going to be adding an additional of story active reality. So an additional story we're going to be getting. Coliseum entry stamp. Not sure what that's going to mean. I think that's like the emotes or something that we have. There's going to be a daily Grimoire feature. So I'm not sure if this relates to we get a free daily summon or if this is they're going to rotate a daily banner. Not sure 100% on that. So we'll have to see. And then they're going to have the gorilla event access keys. Basically means that outside of the time gorilla events, they're going to start giving up keys probably for event rewards or login rewards or mission rewards, something like that, where you guys can get those so that, like, you could just stock them up. And when you get a new weapon, you really want to level right away. If you're not in a guerrilla event, then you guys can basically, from there, use those keys to get your EXP materials. And then we got bug fixes. Fix guerrilla notification bug will soon be activated after altering server settings version 2.3. Then we have fix line break display on the weapon details screen, fix problem of skipping conversations, and the paranoia feature. No idea what that even is. I guess that's, I guess people weren't able to skip the paranoia, like, stuff when, like, something's happening in the game, like when you go through, like, a level or something. And then fix error messages display in Japanese within connection fails. Okay. We are constantly working on fixing minor problems not listed below. So the other things that you guys are experiencing, chances are they're aware of it and working on fixing them. Improvements, item list loading time improvement, target cancellation function, other UI, UX improvements, item stacking not scheduled yet. So I think the item stack means that they're talking about consolidating all the inventories into one thing, and then everyone that use your gems to increase your inventory space for a select part of your inventory should get refunded, from what I understand. But not sure 100%, and the known issues list coming soon. So hopefully they are working on that eventually. So version 2.3, that's gonna be is gonna be released, I would assume, with the update here. And then version 3.0 is for mid-December, and then 2.4 is coming soon. So the 2.4 version, that's going to be like just like kind of the like error stuff, not really any kind of game quality of life updates, just errors within the game. But version 3 is when we were going to see the new story, Colosseum entry stamp, the daily grimoire feature, the gorilla keys, and all that stuff. But we are going to be getting the player craft increase tomorrow with the first update. And then mid-September is when we can expect some of these other things coming to the game. So that is everything I have for you guys in today's video. I hope you guys are excited, and for you guys still doing Sinoalice, that you guys are excited to see all these new updates, quality of life. I am pretty happy that developers are listening to the community and that they are trying to make changes with things wrong with the game. I know the other big thing that I know that even like Tectone mentioned in one of his videos a couple weeks ago is that us having to completely uninstall the game and then reinstall the game when transferring between devices. That definitely needs to get fixed as soon as possible. That makes it very hard for people they want to play in an emulator and they also want to play on their phone, or say they play primarily at home on their tablet and then they want to have it on their phone when they're out and about. Like, it's a mobile game. We should be able to log into a different device and it should be seamless. It should not require you to re-download, re-enter your password, re-enter your username, all that stuff every time you go back and forth between devices. So they definitely need to fix that very soon. I think that needs to be like really considered to be updated in the 3.0 update. I'm hoping they'll add that in there, maybe, but they don't mention it here at all, which is a bad sign. But let me know, guys, what you guys want to see added to the game, fixes, anything like that that you think that should be in these dev notes that aren't. And let me know if you guys are excited for the update coming tomorrow. If you guys did enjoy today's content, as always, make sure you guys drop a like down below, hit subscribe, you guys are new, and ring that bell for future notifications so you do not miss the next Sinoalice video here on the channel. I thank you guys so much for watching once again, and we'll see you all in the next Sinoalice video.